are dynoing this 454 daily driver, twin turbo Ford. Really excited about it because the Fords really like this super tough package that, you know, you don't see a lot of. And I really like the new look of the Ford that we have here. And it, this, of course, is like air conditioning, power steering, alternator, double injector per cylinder, all in a really nice, you know, really nice tight package. And I hope you guys like what you see. I'm pretty stoked on it. Let's get to dynoing. Okay, guys, we're back doing videos. Holy moly. So what we're looking at here is a 454 cubic inch Ford Windsor. Yes, it's a Windsor for all you Ford guys. I know you've been wanting to see some Ford stuff recently, so pretty cool. We got, you know, we did a Ford mount header, which I'm kind of stoked on. I really like the, we normally do them low slung on the Fords, but this looks pretty cool. Wish we'd had the anteater polished, but got to get this one finished. And it's got some, you know, small air to airs on it. This particular motor's got a small little hydraulic cam, so it's really a, like a, you know, a street car daily driver setup. Got a billet specialties true track on there, you know, power steering's off of it, but it's got all the accessories, and basically it's gonna be one bad little sucker. Using our big block Chevy upper plenum and throttle body, it's got dual injector per cylinder. Got the rakes tucked in back, and all in all, I don't know. I think for a Ford, that's about as sexy as it gets on the small block Ford that we've done. We did a black one that I was in love with too. So if you haven't seen that one on YouTube, that's a cool one also. So here's a look at that last pull, 24 pounds of boost. Yes, this O2 is dead, so I don't want to hear how, but it's lean as hell. But 24 pounds of boost, and at 4,100 RPM, I'm really about half throttle there. I'm just kind of taking it easy on the dyno. So it'll actually, this thing will easily flash 24 pounds of boost, even down in the 3,000 RPM range where the, you know, the torque down low would easily be 1,200. But you can see where I kind of get into it. Right around 4,500, you know, 1,338 foot-pounds at 4,800, 1,340 horsepower in climbing, and, you know, it's just a great, fantastic little package right there for something that's so mellow. So let's take a look at some of these other pulls here. Well, here is a pretty mild pull, 6 pounds of boost. 728 foot-pound peak, 708 horsepower at 6.7 pounds of boost. You know, not too shabby right there. 12-pound pull, 898 foot-pounds, 874 horsepower. Again, mild timing, you know, you actually get over here to the O2 that actually is correct. It's actually banging 10 there, so it's a little fat. But 874 horsepower, no doubt. All right, here's a 16-pound pull, 1,061 foot-pound, 1,021 horsepower on the climb. And, you know, just fattiness. Obviously, down 41, again, I'm not really in the throttle there, so that probably would be 1,000 foot-pounds down there if I was. But, you know, good little motor on the climb. Okay, so another pull here. 21 pounds of boost, 1,182 foot-pounds, 1,177 horsepower. I think we can pretty much easily say that's 1,200 horsepower if I keep it going there. So 1,200 horse at 21 pounds. You know, nothing, not breaking records, but definitely working good.
It's the same.